question.
I don't think that today we saw the real ability of Fyrstenberg and Matkowski, am I right?
Well, obviously we're really disappointed about the match. We had a good chance before going to this tie. In doubles, we know it's going to be tough against Yanni and Andy, but we started really very well and everything broke down for us when they broke us in the second set. They were a better team from that, but for sure we didn't play to our standards.
As the top-ranked doubles players, did you feel more pressure after going 0 out of 2?
Well, I think we didn't feel that much. Obviously, no, it's the other way. I think we have more pressure going in 1 out of a tie because it's very deciding then. I think Yanni and Andy had a bit of advantage going to 0 because they knew if something happens and they're going to lose, they're still 2-1 up, and having Duda Sela playing against our Gajanovic, his favorite to win, so they have a cushion of confidence and they just took it to us and we knew we have to win the match, stay in it, but they played better.
Some very high quality doubles today, I think. Do you agree, all in all?
Well, from their side, for sure, they start playing much better from the second set when they broke us. As I said, third and fourth set, they're playing very well and they put a pressure on my serve especially. But as I said before, I think we didn't play as well as we could, and obviously it's pretty disappointing because we wanted to win, but they were just better. I mean, look at the score, 3-4 set, they were 3-1, so there's nothing we can say.
Some people say that in Davis Cup, the crowd is allowed to act more freely than in regular ATP or... Sorry?
Who said that?
Well, let's say people, okay? People that watch the games. Some people say, not only in Israel, but from other countries as well, that the crowd is allowed to act more freely.
I think the crowd is not allowed. I think the crowd want to win their team very much, and that's why they're acting very loud. But it's not about any rule. It's like, I think on the other, you wouldn't see that on the other, even World Cup matches, World Group matches. So, yeah, we are used to it because sometimes we play matches against some local team, and like in Brazil, it was very, very noisy, and we don't think it bothers us. But it's not normal.
I have to say it's pretty annoying for going four set every time after his first and second set people are clapping. I mean, obviously we're gonna play here once. We're not coming back for the next tournament or Davis Cup, hopefully. But I mean, if playing four sets and everybody's clapping first and second set, and the umpire and the referee cannot do anything about it, because they say they cannot control the crowd. I mean, there's something wrong, but it doesn't take any credit from doesn't take anything from Andy and Johnny because they play better today. But I'm just saying that it's not a regular match and it doesn't happen.
You think there shouldn't be any exceptions because it's Davis Cup?
No, there should be exceptions. Of course, the club is involved and they're helping local team, and that's natural. I mean, everybody wants to win, but if the referee is saying every time that please don't clap after first and second serve or before the serve, and they're doing this for a whole match, I mean, what can you do?
But the referee can give penalties.
Well, yeah, but you see, I mean, he didn't say, and the referee didn't say anything, and we didn't want to argue about it because obviously they play better. And what's the point?
For a few years now.